Good afternoon, Southeast Texas. Broke some records again today. Our new warmest high is 82 degrees. That was our high for today, and 73 for that low. So we broke those records set back in 1917 and 1966. And as we head into Sunday's forecast, we're going to be looking at about a 34 or 35 degree difference. So because of that cold front, it is pulling in some great Arctic air, and it will be dropping down our temperatures into the 30s. And for our highs, I mean, we may not even get out of the 40s. 49 degrees is what I'm forecasting. But overall, right now, pretty quiet. It looks like we aren't seeing any showers out on radar. Maybe a little bit right here, a little shower up towards Tyler County. But overall, it's going to be a dry forecast, about a 20% coverage. Those clouds will start to pull on out of the area as we head into tonight. And that cold front does pull through around 3 a.m. Wind advisory is in effect until tomorrow around 9 p.m. So those gusts, they're going to be reaching about 35 to 40 miles per hour. Those are gusts. Sustaining is going to be around 10 to 20 miles per hour. Freeze watch is in effect for the triangle at least until 10 a.m. Monday, and a freeze warning for the lakes area. We could be dipping down to around that 32 degree mark. That's when you get that freeze. I'm forecasting about 34 degrees. National Weather Service is going upper 20s. So remember the four P's: people, plants, pipes, and also your pets. Bring them indoors, keep them warm. So timing of that front looks like around 3-4 a.m. That's when it's going to start to pull through the area, and we're going to see those temperatures just fall down drastically from 70s into the upper 30s and upper 20s for the lakes area. So current temperatures right now, it's still pretty mild out there, about 78 degrees in Kirbyville, 77 in Silsbee, 75 in Beaumont, and across the state already seeing that cold front taking effect. 35 degrees in Dallas right now, seeing some snow up towards the panhandle, 10 degrees in Amarillo, and it looks like those showers are going to be pulling through our area, but mostly off towards the east. Again, I'm not thinking that this is going to be a huge rainmaker. It's all those winds tomorrow. It's going to be a cool, breezy day out there. So you see, high resolution modeling is not really bringing in showers towards us. It's mainly off towards the east of us, and we aren't going to be seeing any severe weather as well. So clouds will start to clear out by around 7 or 8 a.m. with that cold front, and it's going to be a pretty chilly forecast tomorrow morning. You're going to need your winter gear, and it looks like that we will be rising up into the 40s by the afternoon, dropping back down into the 30s by 7 p.m. So wind chills are going to be making it feel like it is 20 degrees up towards the lakes area and low 30s for the triangle. So make sure that you warm up, cover every inch of your skin. You want to wear your layers. Out in the Gulf of Mexico, it's just a no-go. Small craft advisory is in effect. A gale warning as well. Those seas are going to be very rough, and those winds are going to be, that's why the gale warning is in effect. 25 to 30 knots to around 40 as well. For tonight's forecast, just some light rain out there, frosty lakes, and remember the four P's: people, pets, pipes, and plants. I think the pipe should be okay, but you always want to be safe, you know. 40 degrees we are going to be forecasting for the triangle, and as we head into Sunday's forecast, it's going to be cool and windy. Remember, those gusts are going to be reaching about 35, 40 miles per hour, so that wind advisor will be in effect until 9 p.m. tomorrow. Beautiful sunny skies out there, at least for the next several days, middle of the week, and as we head into Thursday's forecast, might get another cold front, which will reinforce those cool conditions, but not for long. It looks like next Saturday we are going to warm back up to pretty much normal average around this time of year. We're going to be in the upper 60s for those highs and low 40s for the lows.
Even though I know to expect it, I'm still going to be shocked when I come outside tomorrow and
it's going to be a chilly forecast. And then we are going to be seeing some frost here in Beaumont as we head into Monday's forecast. So I got a lot of work set out for me. So
yeah, new year with some new weather. Thanks so much, Christiana.